This intraoperative surgical video is a supplement to the case report about a 16-year-old boy with extensive cervicothoracic posterior arch defects from C7 to T6. The boy presented with myelopathy due to stretching of the spinal cord over the apex of the thoracic kyphosis at T4-5. The imaging studies did not reveal any spinal cord tethering. The patient was positioned prone on a horseshoe headrest with Gardner-Wells traction. In this position, the cervical hyperlordosis corrected partially, which allowed for upper thoracic pedicle screw trajectory. A careful exposure of the posterior elements was performed, taking care not to injure the uncovered dural sac. The left side of the screen is the head end and the right is the foot end. The lower thoracic pedicle screws have been inserted from T6 to T9. The meningocele in the cervical region is visible here. A large free-floating spinous process was found at the T4-5 level. This was just behind the apex of the thoracic kyphosis. What is being pointed here are the lateral boundaries of the dysraphism in the upper thoracic region. Those are the transverse processes of T5, T4 and T3. Because of the high convergence angle of the T2 pedicle, a stab incision lateral to the wound was required through which the pedicle finder was passed. Here one can see the ball probe feeler used to palpate the pedicle walls through this stab incision. This is a view from the top where one can appreciate the high convergence angle of the T2 pedicle screw trajectory. The upper thoracic spine was not visible clearly on lateral fluoroscopy. Hence, taking advantage of the midline defect, the pedicle walls were palpated using a probe to ensure correct placement of screws. Polyaxial reduction screws were placed in T2, T3 and T4 to help ease rod capture and reduction of the kyphosis after osteotomy. Bilateral extracavitary approach was performed after removing proximal portions of the T5 rib. The T5 vertebra was decancellated first, leaving behind the posterior elements intact. An omega-shaped working rod was locked into the screws to facilitate two surgeons who were operating simultaneously. Then the free-floating spinous processes were gently dissected off the dural sac. There were no adhesions and it could be removed easily. After thinning down the posterior wall of the T5 vertebral body, the remainder of the bony wall was gently broken down into the ventral cavity. Once complete 360-degree decompression was confirmed, the kyphosis was corrected by gradually capturing the reduction screws over contoured rods. The osteotomy defect was simultaneously shortened over a 10 mm cage. And this was the final construct. Thank you for watching.